There's a huge controversy now after the Ministry of Home Affairs did not renew the foreign donation, the foreign contribution license for the Missionaries of Charity. That, of course, is the charity founded by Mother Teresa. So this wasn't renewed. So today, the accounts of the Missionaries of Charity were frozen. They said they did that because that they were no longer eligible, or it was no longer legal for them to receive foreign donations. The ministry's decision to not renew this license, the FCRA license, came just this Saturday on Christmas, a national holiday. So a huge controversy now erupting over the Ministry of Home Affairs' decision not to renew the license. Sunil Prabhu has more on this. Sunil, we've seen the political controversy, but what are the facts? Why would the government decide not to renew the foreign contribution license of an internationally known charity set up by Mother Teresa, declared a saint by the Vatican, and of course praised by India then as well?
That's right, Sonia, and as you rightly said,
So we've got a slight problem with Sunil's line there. We'll come back to that. But just as we look at the various tweets that came in, where first from the West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, saying she was shocked to hear that on Christmas the Union Ministry froze all bank accounts of Mother Teresa's Missionary Charity in India, saying that 22,000 patients and employees have been left without food and medicine. While the law is paramount, she said, humanitarian efforts must not be compromised. So Sunil, as I said, the argument over this, what is the government telling you about why they didn't renew that license?
Well, the adverse inputs that they are alleging is that because there have been some irregularities in the audit report. They are saying very categorically this has nothing to do with conversion. There is, of course, a process for review as well as a request which can be looked at. So no doors are closed at the present, but definitely the Missionaries of Charity have got a rude and terrible Christmas gift on the 25th of which is also really something that they didn't expect, and it's in that that they're doing it with abundant caution. Their lawyers as well as chartered accountants will work with the Ministry of Home Affairs to try and resolve this at the earliest.
And I think the main issue really, as both the Archbishop of Calcutta and Mamata Banerjee said, is what happens to all the people who receive care from the Missionaries of Charity, as I said, one of India's most well-known and well-respected charities. Now, is there any links? Because Sunil, of course, you've seen all the controversy of the anti-conversion bill in Karnataka being passed, the attacks we've seen on churches, even on Christmas. So is there any link? What does the government say to charges of how this is part of a larger conspiracy against the Christian community?
Well, Sonia, you yourself can point out that there is nobody from the top political brass who have condemned those series of events that have taken place. So if you ask many people, be it political parties and others, this is something that is really which has shocked them. And there is definitely a pattern that they believe has taken place. Nevertheless, the Ministry of Home Affairs, when I specifically asked them whether there is a possibility of some kind of organized attack or what they call a program against the Christians, they make it very clear that they are taking various measures to safeguard and ensure that the minorities are safe, and making it also abundantly clear that Mother Teresa's work is respected. It has nothing to do with conversion. There are certain irregularities after the FCRA guidelines have become far more cumbersome, far more stringent, and it's in that backdrop that they have rejected the FCRA request. We'll have to wait and see what exactly happens, but definitely nationally as well as internationally, this action is definitely going to come under a scanner.